Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling outdoorsy and woodsy because I am recording this demo, the first ever demo that we've recorded from the Dotto cabin in the interior of BC. Yes, indeed. Early October means the fish are hungry, which means I am visiting to see if they want to commune with me a little bit. And I thought this trip here that it would be a great opportunity to test to see if we could record demos while we're back in our cabin. It'll give me a lot of great work-life balance if this indeed works out. So our big experiment today is doing a demo from the Dotto cabin. And what a demo we have. While I was sitting out there in the middle of the lake, the folks at Evernote were ever so busy at their convention back in civilization talking about a brand new interface for Evernote. Now, this is something that causes much anxiety amongst Evernote users because we rely on Evernote and it has to work the way we work. So any change in the Evernote interface is a big deal. And this is a big change. Oh, yes, indeed. You're going to want to check it out today on Dotto Tech. All right, the folks at Evernote have been taking a look at how we use Evernote, and they've come up with what they consider to be a bit of a concern, and that is the concern of distraction, which actually is a real interest of mine. The concept of distraction, we all know how distracted we are in today's connected world. There's always something vying for our attention. In fact, distraction is such an issue for me that I stopped using multiple monitors on my desktop computer and went to a single monitor so that I wasn't having the constant distraction of something else happening. And Evernote recognizes that right within their interface is a tremendous amount of distraction. So if you're using Evernote not just as a storage and retrieval mechanism, but as a content creation tool where you're actually writing content within Evernote, which many of us do, well, then these extra layers of information that are constantly made available to us can indeed become a distraction. Case in point, take a look at this screen here, a typical Evernote screen. We've got down the left-hand side, we've got our navigation area. We've got a list of all of our notes down the center. And then the content that we should be working on, our note itself, on the right-hand side. So if I go to create a new note and I start writing away, I've got all of these little siren songs over here saying, come look at me, Steve. Come visit with me. Come see what I'm doing. Especially when I run into something difficult and I am writing along and all of a sudden I, you know, suffer writer's block and I sit there and I ponder at the screen, I've got all of these bright and shiny objects kind of attracting me off to the side. That is what we're talking about as far as distraction is concerned. But let's layer that on top of one other concern that Evernote has, and that Evernote is not presented the same in all of our platforms. We use Evernote on our smartphone, on our tablet. We use it on the web. We use it as a desktop app, such as you're seeing here. So when Evernote faces all of these different challenges, they then had to decide how they were going to try and reduce the amount of distraction, but still giving us the same amount of functionality on these different devices. So what they've decided to do, apparently, is to just give it to us first in the web client, which I think is a pretty good idea. The web client is universally accessible, but it's also probably for most of us the client that we use a little less than we would be using the desktop client or the mobility client. Now, your own personal use might be different, but I'm speaking from personal experience that I use the web client a little bit less. So great place to put it to start. But they still have to be full of anxiety over trying this out because there's going to be a big backlash, whether it's good, whether it's bad. Evernote's going to hear it. Do you want to see what it looks like? I think we should. So picture in your mind now the cacophonous nature of this screen that we're looking at and how difficult it would be to concentrate on any work while you're staring at this screen. And then let's go over and let's look at Evernote's new screen. So this is the Evernote web interface with a new note. This is what you're presented with when you log in and you accept the beta version on the web. And it's this very clean interface. Evernote says that they want the interface to melt into the background when you're working and then come back to the foreground when you need it. And they've really increased the amount of white space. They've increased the amount of white space to the point that it's almost like a white sheet of paper. So you just basically, you can start typing, you can title your note, you can start typing away within your note, and notice what happens as soon as you start typing is the entire interface disappears. All we have back here now is our web browser. And if you wanted to completely minimize this, you could also hide all of the menus in your web browser, and you would just have basically a white sheet of paper to be putting your ideas on. That is a tremendous benefit if you're looking to reduce the amount of distraction. When you're finished, you click done. And now here is where many Evernote users might begin to hyperventilate, because they'll be going, where's my stuff? Where did my stuff go? I'm used to seeing tons of my stuff here. Well, it's all still here, but it's nested underneath these different menus. So we create a new note by clicking here. We do our search, which we often use in Evernote here. So yes, we can still search in Evernote. What's big missing for me and big is the shortcuts. I use the shortcuts for notes that I return to always, but I can get to my shortcuts just by clicking here on this screen here. And then you can see all of your notes and yeah, everything's there. There's all my notebooks. I'm starting to feel a little bit more comfortable. Okay, Evernote's still got everything here. It's just a little bit hidden. It just looks a little bit different. I like this idea. I applaud them for attacking the issue of distraction, which I think is an increasing productivity concern in our workplace today. So good on them for doing it. I know they will be criticized somewhat by some different sectors for changing things so dramatically, and some people will feel that they can't access all of their stuff, and after all, that is what Evernote is all about, is having access to our stuff. But I think this is a great idea. Now, do I think that this is going to migrate into the desktop client and become part of the desktop client? I could see how they could make a view within the desktop client, but I think they're going to have to keep all of that information together for you, for the most part, in the desktop client. So this might be the beginning of a new product from Evernote, a new writing and a new creation product, or it might be a different view that might be available ultimately in the desktop client. They haven't told us how they plan to migrate it across. And of course, it probably is not going to work at all in the smartphone space. So this is Evernote now layering some additional functionality on top. Overall, I'm going to give it a thumbs up. I like it as a start, and I will certainly work in it as I do my writing and as I do that sort of work. I'm going to give it a good shot and give it a try. I actually have a few minimalist word processors installed on my computer. This will definitely replace them as far as I'm concerned. Well, I hope you found today's video to be useful. I hope you don't mind visiting me here at the cabin here, and I hope you don't mind that I'm looking a little more weathered than I normally look for one of our videos, and no green screen. You get to see the cabin behind us the whole time. If you enjoy this video and you found it useful, there are three ways that you can stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is, of course, please subscribe to this channel. The second is you can subscribe to our newsletter, where I send out a weekly digest of all of our videos, as well let you know about any special events, any webinars or courses that we might be offering here on Dotto Tech. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel. We are supported by you, our patrons, through the crowdfunding site Patreon. For as little as $1 a month, you can make sure that I can concentrate on just producing content without worrying about going out and finding advertising and spending all my time trying to make the channel monetize itself. So I encourage you to drop by, visit our Patreon page, see what patronage is all about, and if it's something that tickles your fancy, then I appreciate the fact that you might consider becoming a patron of Dotto Tech. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.